Hello student, welcome to digital classes. This video is for class 8. Subject is maths and this is the continue of the chapter number 3, square and square root. In the previous video I told you about how we take out the square root of any number by using prime factorization method. In exercise 3D is basically related to the prime factorization, or this is the fourth part of this chapter, or this video is related to exercise 3D and exercise 3F both. In this video I can discuss some question, more question, and then I tell you about the long division method, square root. How do you find the square root by the long division method? It's E, sorry, D E, not F. I forget about this. Sorry. Now, in example number 7, in previous video I told you about the example number 6, now the example number 7, find the least square number divisible by each 8, 9 and 10. So I think better we can do the exercise question number 17. This is exercise 3D and the question number 17. Other we can discuss because this is a different type of question. So I want to discuss. Find the least square number which is exactly divisible by each of the numbers 6, 9 and 15 and 20. Means we have to find a number that is divisible by, we have to find a number that is divisible by 6, 9, 15 and 20. In this case, we have to find the LCM of these numbers. So, first we take out the LCM of these numbers. First I write it like this. Solution. LCM of 6, 9, 15 and 20. So, by a long division method of LCM, this is 6, 9, 15 and 20. So, you see most of the number is divisible by 2 or 3. So, we start with 2. 2, 3 is a 9, 15 and now it is 10. Now, I do with 3. It is 1, 3, 5 and 10. Then we do again with 3. It will be 3, 5 and 10. Now we do with 5. It's 1, it's 2. Then do with 1. So, this is the prime factorization. LCM of 6, 9, 15 and 20 is equal to 2 times 2 times 3 times 3 times 5. And this is the question. Find the least square number which is exactly divisible by 6, 9, 15 and 20. So, there is one number less to make it a square. So, to required number, required number which must be multiplied by the LCM of 6, 9, 15 and 20 to become perfect square. Perfect square is equal to 5. Okay. Now you can just multiply this. 2 to the 4, or you can multiply like this, 5 to the 10, 2 the 20, 23 is a 60, and 63 is a 180. So required number is equal to 180 multiplied by 5, and we know that 18 5 is a 90, so it will be 900. So 900 is the least number, so therefore 900 is the least square number, least square number, that is 900 is the least square number which must be divisible by 6, 9, 15 and 20. So this is the answer. So now it is clear. So 17, we have to find a number that is exactly divisible, square number that is exactly divisible by 6, 9, 15 and 20. So first we have to find out the LCM of 6, 9, 15 and 20. We get a LCM, that is 180. So the required number must be multiplied by the LCM of 6, 9, 15 and 20 to become a perfect square is equal to 5. Now the required number is equal to 180 multiplied by 5, which is equal to 900. And 900 is the least square number which must be divisible by 6, 9, 15 and 20. So I think it is clear. The rest we can discuss in a class. Now let us find out a square root. Find out a square root by long division method or a division method. Both are same. Long division method. Okay. Now, suppose. Just you take a bigger number, then it will be good for you. Now let us take an example. Number 1, 1, 6, 3, 8, 4. We have to find out the square root of 1, 6, 3, 8, 4 by long division method. See, you can make a table like this first. This is a line. You can draw like this. Then you have to write the number in this. Okay. Now, the very first thing you can do, make a pair from the right side. Clear? You have to make a pair from the right side and put a bar over it. Now, this is 84 is the pair, 63, and now 1 is the last. And you have to make a pair from the right to left. Make a pair from the right to left. It is very much important to put a bar from the right to left. Okay. And now we divide this number by a squaring number. Like 1 times 1, which is 1. So this will be cancelled. Now it is 63. Now, what is this number 1? So you can add 1. So it will become 2. You have to find a number like... See, I will tell you, 23 times 3 is 3, 3 is 9, 3, 2 is 6. So, you have to use a square number at the unit digit. You have to, suppose you have to use 3 here, then you have to write 3 here also. So we just checked, 23 times 3 is 69. So I think we have to use 22 times 2. So you have to write 2 here and 2 here also. Then 22 2s are 44. Now 13, 4 is 9 and this is 5 and 9. And now you have to take a number, group of number to put right here. Means you have to take out two numbers simultaneously. Because this is in a bar or this is a group. So you have to, and in case of this also, you have to take out a two number that is in a group together. So here it is 1, now here it is 2, so you can add 2 here. So it will be 24. Now you have to find a number here and then the same number you have to write here. So 2, 4, and we know that the unit digit is 4. So I think 2 times 2 is 4 and 8 times 8 is 64. The unit digit is 4 here. So we can multiply this by 8 because this is 19. If we multiply this by 2, so it will be just a very small number. 2 to the 4 and 4 to the 8 and 2 to the 4, 448. So better we use, and your number is a 4 digit number, so you can multiply with 8. 8 8 is a 64, 6 carry. 8 4 is a 32, 32 plus 6 is 8, 3 carry. 8 2 is a 16 plus 3, 19. So you have to write 8 here and here also. So 1984 is subtracted from this. Now the remainder is 0. So you have to write like this. Under root 16384 is equal to 128. This is the square root of 16384, which is equal to 128. So in this question, two things is very important. One, you have to make a bar from the right to left, and second, you have to add the unit digit number with same. Like if it is a 1, so you add with 1. If it is a 2, then you add with 2. And suppose if there is more number, you can add 8 here because the 8 is the unit digit number. But not in this question. Your answer is completed. Under root of 16384 is equal to 128. Under root of 16384 is equal to 128. Sorry. Now let us take one more example for this method. Suppose we can take a very little big number from the exercise 3E. And this is the question number 12. We are finding the square root of 92416. 92416 means 92,416. You have to make a this arrangement for every question, and then write 92416. And the very first thing, you have to put bar from the right to left. Clear? Now, here is 9. So we can use, suppose, squaring number like 2 into 2, which is equal to 4. 3 into 3, we know that 9. So we can use 3 and 3 here. First we write here and then here. Then it will become 9. Cancel. Now the 24, the group of the number comes down. This is 24. Now we add 3 over here and it will be 6. 3 plus 3 is 6. Now the interesting thing comes here. Suppose if we take 1, then this is smaller. But in the division, what we do? We put 0 and take down the another number. But now see, here if we place 1, it 61 times 1 is less than 24. Then what we do? We put 0 here. And then 0 here also. Then use 0 and 0. Then 2416 is the number. And you add 0 here, it will become 60. And now you have to find the unit digit number for this. Now 6. Unit digit is 6. And we know that when we multiply 4 times 4, it becomes 6 at the unit place. And 6 times 6, 36, the unit digit is 6. Means that 4 and 6, 4 or 6 is possible here only. So let us see. I tell you this to find out for make your calculation easy, or you can save your time while calculating the square root. So it is important to check this. If you don't want to check, you can multiply with any number. It's up to you. You want to save your time or not. Now 60, and we have to take suppose 4, so it will be 4 fours are 16 and 4 six are 24. So we can write 4 here and 4 here also. 2416 is our number. Now it cancelled, so it means the remainder is 0. And now under root 92416 is equal to 304 is our answer. Now it is clear. So I think you can understand. There is two thing is important. One is the bar. One is the bar, which we have to make from the, which we have to make from the right to left. And second thing, add the unit digit number. Same unit digit number with the for doing the sum. So I think now this is clear. I think now it is clear. Now move to the question number 13. Exercise 3E, question number 13. The question is, find the least number which must be subtracted from 2509 to make it a perfect square number. So we know that 2509 is not a perfect square number, and the question is, what must be subtracted? What must be subtracted from 2506 to make it a perfect square? So first we have to find the square root of this. Let's see by division method. This question is solved only with the help of division method, long division method. 2509, we put a bar over here, 09 and 25. So we know that it is 5 5s are 25, and this is cancelled, now it's 0. So 5 plus 5 is 10. And in our division fact, same, when you divide 22 upon this, see, 22, 2 1s are 2, now it's cancelled, so we have to put 0 over here to get the remainder. This is a division fact, and this is also applicable in this also. So you can use 0 here, it will become 50. So 0 0 and now 9. Clear? So 9 is the number which must be subtracted from. So what is the question? The least number. The least number is equal to 9. So 9 is the number that must be subtracted from 2509 to make it a perfect square number. Suppose 2509 minus 9, which is equal to 2500, and under root 2500 is equal to the answer here 50. This is the way to find out how to solve this question. I repeat the question. Find the least number which must be subtracted from 2509 to make it a perfect square number. Our number is 2509. What must be subtracted from 2509 to make it a perfect square? First we do the prime factorize, first we do the square root by long division method, and this question is only possible with long division method. So our remainder is 9, so the least number is 9. If we subtract 9 from 2905, so it will be 2500, and under root of 2500 is equal to 50. This is the solution for this answer, this question. So rest we will discuss within a class.